Your forecast, we're outside right now looking at a quiet start to the day. However, I am seeing a few pop-up storms already developing to the west of Alma. So from Gratiot and Isabella counties, these areas, even near Clinton County, could see a better chance for a shower storm. We've got the one near East Lansing that may try and clip the Gratiot and Saginaw County line here as we go into the next hour. Aside from that, most of us starting out beautiful this morning. Lots of sunshine back in store for us. It's been kind of cloudy the last few days, so happy to talk about more sunnier skies than the cloudier ones. We're looking at 60 already in Grand Blanc and Lapeer. We're at 57 in Freeland and Cass City. We're at 50 right now in Gladwin and Tawa, so kind of a 10 degree temperature difference from north to south. But we are all going to be warming up into the upper 70s and low 80s today. I think most of us will actually make it between 80 and 82 degrees. So widening out, not a lot to talk about now. We've just got that initial band of showers that's developing. That is actually on the outflow, the rain cooled air that pushed out from showers and storms that were in Indiana last night. And as we look a bit more to the south, we've got more showers and storms that have developed across Ohio and getting into Kentucky, West Virginia. Here's this area of low pressure. I've been tracking it all week long, and that's the same one that's moving out to the west, but the circulation around that area of low pressure, it's counterclockwise. So on the eastern side of it, where we are, we're getting the south and southeast winds, and that's what's bringing back the humidity, also bringing in the clouds, and these clouds and the moisture streaming all the way from the Gulf of Mexico. So we do have at least a chance today and tomorrow, even Friday and Saturday, for all the fireworks and 4th of July activities and festivities that you may be enduring. We are going to talk about that pop-up shower and storm risk. One or two could be severe, specifically for today. I think today we may have a little bit of a wind gust or a hail threat, but it's going to be a very isolated threat. So this is 4 o'clock this afternoon. Futurecast really pops the storms in the southwestern part of the mitten, and I think that will be the better area, at least the higher chances to see those scattered showers and storms. Watch what happens though by 10 o'clock tonight. Here we are in Chesaning, here we are in Frankenmuth, and we lose all that shower and thunderstorm activity. And that's exactly what typically happens in the summertime. You get daytime heating, temperatures into the 80s, that sunshine keeps things going. But once the sun sets, we lose daytime heating, and that causes the showers and storms to fizzle out. And that's what I am expecting to occur today and also tomorrow. So don't cancel any of your outdoor plans, but just keep in mind that if these storms do develop, there's so much heat out there today and tomorrow, one or two could be strong to severe, but we're not looking at a widespread organized event. And if you're celebrating tomorrow afternoon, maybe taking the kids out to the lake or the pool, yeah, the family barbecue, we've got a nice forecast coming up for us and a warm one. Again, getting back to more summer-like territory, what we should be at this time of year, which is right around 82. So 82 today, 82 tomorrow. We're going up into the mid 80s though by the time we head from Friday into Saturday. There is that risk for a shower or storm chance every day, but it's only at about 20 to maybe 30% chances of showers and storms each and every afternoon. So